Numeracy in post-primary education. Rationale. As pre-service teachers, we have now had an adequate experience of teaching in schools as a collective, we were drawn in particular to the lack of numeracy skills within second level education in all our subject areas, for example, in particular, mental arithmetic. We began to ask ourselves the problem and look at our own experience of incorporating numeracy in our lessons in order to evaluate what we were doing wrong. We felt as though literacy and numeracy can often be looked at as a box to check in lesson plans, with many student teachers not fully understanding how to incorporate numeracy in the classroom, despite this being a key skill for all students. In order to address this issue collectively, we set out with the plan of addressing what numeracy actually is, why it is beneficial to our students, why it is being lost in the classroom, in particular the lack of cross-curricular links between subject areas. We then also looked at discussing the problem with peers and colleagues, both young and experienced, in order to look at possible solutions to this as future educators. What is our issue, our focus? Like I've said, as I mentioned before, previously, the first step was to identify the problem in our schools. We found that numeracy, although a key skill we aim to teach in our students, is something that teachers struggle to understand, let alone implement in the classroom. The Department of Education and Skills in 2011 said, "Numeracy encompasses the ability to use mathematical understanding and skills to solve problems and meet the demands of day-to-day living in complex social settings." This problem became all the more puzzling when addressing the new junior cycle reform, in which literacy and numeracy in tandem were key goals of the reform and areas that were of apparent interest in development in our schools. The junior cycle reform looks to put the key skills of numeracy and literacy to the fore. So now we decided to look at how and why this should be implemented in our classroom and the multitude of benefits that this can have for students both in and out of schools. As we can see, there is clearly an emphasis on numeracy skills in the NCCA website. For example, expressing ideas mathematically, seeing patterns, trends, relationships, and then using digital technology to develop numeracy skills and understanding, clearly put to the fore. Why teach numeracy? We see in many studies and cases why it is important to include numeracy in our teaching, but often teachers are left struggling to implement this in lessons. Numeracy is no doubt a key skill that is effective in the classroom. However, students often seem to categorize this skill as something done solely in the maths class. Numeracy skills are used in every subject, and it is clear that due to this problem of cross-curricular links, students struggle to implement these skills in other subject areas such as geography, technical graphics, PE, and wood technology. Upon research, we found that Ireland ranks significantly lower in relation to numeracy skills than that of literacy skills, and quickly we felt that this topic was something that we needed to research in detail. Our goal is to address this problem while also looking at possible solutions that could be implemented in our classrooms and our teacher training for the betterment of our teachers and students. This is mirrored by Benison. If all teachers are able to identify and exploit the numeracy learning opportunities that exist in subjects they teach, then students' numeracy capabilities, along with learning in each subject, is likely to be enhanced.
Why are numeracy skills being lost? One of the key questions. Are teachers actively trying to show students the links? From my research, in many cases, teachers are not making the numeracy connection within their own subject discipline and that of the subject discipline of mathematics. This is consequently having a severe disadvantage to students, as they are being taught different ways of getting the same answer. Confusion and frustration arises in pupils as they are not being allowed to use the formula that were taught in maths class. As a well-known fact, better teaching will support better learning. It is well known that using similar equations and formulas for numeracy development across cross-curricular subjects like maths, geography and construction studies will improve the learning outcomes. Students should be advised by the teachers to use more cross-curricular numeracy skills in their classes. Teachers also need to be better trained by universities to deliver numeracy properly in the classroom, while also teacher communication within the staff room needs to improve to understand what's being covered in similar subject disciplines. So also, why are numeracy skills being lost? Are students getting worse in mental arithmetic? Yes, at an increasing rate, it's been proven pupils are less proficient at simple mental maths, adding and subtracting. While memorization is important to developing numeracy, deep learning is also a key requirement to realize each solution. So the definition of mental arithmetic falls under the realm of being able to think cognitively through the arithmetic mathematics without using a calculator. Society also has attitudes which have a negative influence on mental arithmetic. Maths is hard. Only some people are good at maths. You'll never use algebra after leaving cert. So these are all having a negative impact on numeracy development in schools. Is technology having an impact? The use of iPads and other software is essential to developing numeracy at young age. Technology is used in data representation, such as graphs, tables, curves, and can be constructed on a computer easily to display the findings of a mathematical study. However, as we all know, social media is having a negative impact on numeracy development of our pupils through the instant need for fulfillment.
In order to discuss the issue further with our peers and colleagues, we first needed to delve deeper into each of our own experiences while on school placement. We noticed students had issues with mental arithmetic in both the maths classroom and beyond. During discussions and planning, we also noticed that as pre-service teachers, we at times felt like we had to plan for numeracy in our lessons, even if we didn't implement it, just to tick the box. As we discussed this point further, we came to a conclusion. This was that while we had heard an awful lot about the importance of including both literacy and numeracy in our lessons, were we ever really taught how to include them in a meaningful and worthwhile way? Some of us didn't feel confident that when we included numeracy in a lesson, that it was truly meaningful to the students' learning experience. We wanted to explore this point further. To do this, we created a short survey which was shared with both pre-service teachers and qualified teachers. The survey's focus was on whether teachers planned for numeracy in the classroom, if they followed through with it, and on teachers' competency in including numeracy in an effective, meaningful way in their lesson. Different surveys were given to pre-service and qualified teachers in order to keep the data separate. This allowed for us to easily compare and contrast the answers. The questions on each survey were the same. These first two pie charts display rather similar percentages in the amount of pre-service and qualified teachers who do and do not plan for and include numeracy skills in their unit learnings and lesson plans. As can be seen in the pie charts, over 80% of both samples plan to include numeracy skills in their classroom. We felt that this was to be expected. What was more alarming was the percentage of pre-service and qualified teachers who plan to include numeracy skills but then do not implement it in the lesson. As can be seen from the pie charts, 57.7% of pre-service teachers include numeracy in their lesson plan and didn't actually implement it when teaching the lesson. If teachers answered yes to this question, they were asked to give an explanation as to why. Some reasons that we got back included: there is no clear strategy for implementing numeracy, put it in just for the tutor at times, and difficult to maintain their attention when they just want to play sport in PE. And a number of the pre-service teachers also stated that time was an issue. The qualified teachers who participated in the survey were split 50-50 on if they implemented numeracy or not. Their explanations were similar in ways to the pre-service teachers. They said time, forgetting as practical lessons are hectic, and because they were required to by the school-wide template. Finally, we asked about confidence. We included this question as we felt that while you can easily throw something about numeracy into a lesson, are you confident it is meaningful and worthwhile for the students' learning? While I wasn't surprised that 34.6% of pre-service students or pre-service teachers weren't confident, I was surprised that 1 in 4 of qualified teachers aren't confident. I find this so surprising, especially since being numerate is one of the junior cycle key skills.
In secondary schools in Ireland, the majority of teachers teach individual subjects. As a result, there is very little overlap and many teachers are unaware of what others are teaching or even what methodologies they are using. Most schools across the country do not have scheduled time slots factored into their timetables, which would allow teachers to meet up and participate in collaborative discussions. Time which would allow teachers to share their ideas on how best to develop cross-curricular links with learning more relevant and meaningful for students. Research has offered potential solutions in how best to deal with some of these barriers. First, we will look at a research-based model addressing 21st century numeracy developed by Marilyn Goose. This was used to develop online CPD resources currently accessible to all teachers. This model has 4 elements. They include mathematical knowledge, dispositions, tools, and context. A numeric person must have mathematical knowledge. This includes using problem-solving, strategies, concept skills, and logical estimates. A numeric person should have a positive disposition, showing both confidence and interest for individual or group tasks. Students can therefore apply their mathematical understanding in a flexible manner. Numeracy practices involve using tools. These include representational, physical, and digital. An example of these would be maps, charts, and scales. Numeracy involves using mathematics to act in and on the world. People need to be numerate in a range of contexts. So approach that is currently being rolled out in several secondary schools in Ireland is the Dive Deep into Numeracy project. It involves a PDST representative and teachers meeting to explore how numeracy can be integrated in a more meaningful way across the curriculum. This collaborative process requires the maths teacher and the teacher of the carrier subjects to meet and identify on an area of numeracy common to both subjects. A unit of learning is then drawn up outlining how each lesson can integrate the agreed topic. This approach brings both uniformity and familiarity to the students' learning process.
So just a quick recap on all the important points we've covered so far. So based on our own experience, from conversations we had with qualified and pre-service teachers, and from research, we all felt that there is a decline in students' numeracy skills in recent years. Ireland is ranked significantly low in numeracy skills in the world, which needs to be changed, as having good numeracy skills is not just beneficial for students to have in school, but also to have it outside of school, so they can complete simple tasks such as completing their own taxes or giving back change in a supermarket. Students may not see the importance of developing this skill, as their teachers are not providing students with the cross-curriculum links between maths and their subject discipline. From the results of the short surveys we conducted, we can see where one of the problems lies in relation to students' poor numeracy skills, as nearly half of the combined pre-service and qualified teachers include numeracy in their planning but don't actually implement it in their lessons, and 30% of those that do implement it don't actually feel confident implementing it effectively in the classroom. So the real question lies in what can we do in secondary schools to support the development of students' numeracy skills both inside and outside of the classroom. So the whole school approach and tools to tackling this issue. As suggested by the PDST, there are many things that secondary schools can do to improve students' numeracy skills. Some of these include displaying numeracy posters throughout the school, signs to classrooms or the office should include distances, students' numeracy work displayed in corridors. As part of a numeracy policy, the language of numbers is taught in every class. Get students to calculate the percentage of marks awarded to each question on the Junior Cert or Leaving Cert papers in your subject. Students asked to record where numeracy occurs in each subject over a period of a week or a month. A number line in every classroom. Stickers giving measurements of doors, windows, or classrooms in each room. Parents invited to a first year maths class where students describe what they are doing. Have a whole school approach, the Maths Eyes initiative. Students are asked to find pictures in magazines or newspapers or take pictures related to a particular team.
Some of these teams are shown below.
So that is the ending of our presentation on numeracy in post-primary education.